I got, Rob. It's the best I got. Bienvenidos a Buzz. That means welcome to the Buzz, but in Spanish, because it's Cinco de Mayo. This is certainly one of the most delicious holidays of the year, and we've got an expert here to help us plan the menu. He's a James Beard Award-winning chef and restaurateur. His cookbook is called The Latin Road Home. There it is. Please welcome Chef Jose Garces. This thing's heavy, man.
It's heavy. Listen, there's some good recipes in there.
Oh, a lot of good. Man, that's like a textbook. We all need that kitchen.
I just want to say, I love the apron.
Do you?
I need that. Yeah, and
how about my apron putter on her?
The apron assistant is perfect. Yeah.
We all need an apron assistant as well.
Absolutely.
Now, any good Cinco de Mayo party worth its salt starts with a good margarita, and you're about to make the top dog.
Absolutely.
The El Jefe. What's happening here?
So the El Jefe, you know, I try to have my margaritas without a hangover in the morning. So the key is really good quality tequila. So
uh-huh.
I use an aged tequila. And how do you like your margaritas? I mean, I like them stiff. I like the taste of tequila.
I like all drinks stiff, apparently. So yes. As long as we're not getting a headache, let's go that route.
Sweet. So this is an aged tequila. I'm gonna put two shots in
there.
That's
where I've been going wrong. I've been buying the cheap tequila all these years.
Yeah. No, that'll hurt you in the morning.
Frugality, is that a word, frugality?
I think so, yeah.
It is now.
So we've got some reposado tequila. We had a little bit of Cointreau, a little orange liqueur.
Nice.
And then we have Ancho Reyes. This is a brand new red chili liqueur that's out on the market. Really nice. It gives a nice kick to our margarita.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to boom, spice it up.
You
ready to shake? We've got fresh orange juice, some lime juice, and simple syrup.
Okay.
Already added in there.
Nice.
Are you a good shaker?
Let's find out.
Go ahead, let's do it. Over the shoulder?
Over the shoulder. Hey!
There you go.
Hey! All right. That was my first time shaking.
That's pretty good.
First time ever.
Not bad.
All right, let's go ahead and get these going, man.
So I'm a rocks, no salt guy.
Yes.
How about you?
All right, perfect. Rocks, no salt. That's perfect for me.
Boom. All right, give
Cheers.
That a shot. Cheers. Happy Cinco de Mayo.
Happy Cinco de Mayo. Now, next, we're moving on to esquites. Am I saying that right?
Esquites.
Esquites.
So I had these in Mexico City a few years back. I was just walking the streets of Mexico, really looking for inspiration for my Mexican mm-hmm. restaurant. And I saw this guy with a giant vat of corn that was warming in a broth and all these delicious garnishes. So they basically just warm the corn in corn broth, epazote, a little bit of chipotle mayo, lime, and queso fresco. And we built one already. Give that a little shot.
So this is kind of like traditional Mexican street food. Really.
Mexican street food, exactly.
Hmm. All right, now next we've got, it looks like a taco, but what's in the... Is it lamb? Is that what I
heard? Yeah, so this is lamb barbacoa.
Never heard of a lamb taco before. That's pretty neat.
Yeah, we like to, you know, mix it up a little bit. And this is a slow-cooked lamb. It has a red chili marinade, and it's wrapped in banana leaves. We picked it up with a little bit of lamb broth and some garlic and onions. I have some fresh-made tortillas, which is key in Cinco de Mayo, the tortillas. We use fresh masa, which my guys brought up. Feel that.
Wow.
You can stick your fingers in there. So we make all of our tortillas with fresh masa.
Oh, man, that's got a little kick to it.
It's got some kick.
I got to go back to my margarita.
There you go.
What a shame.
So we're going to build these tacos up. A little bit. Look at that juicy, delicious lamb.
Well, there you got the nose running over here, man.
Oh, yeah, man. That's exactly it.
Now, I want to emphasize, too, you're opening a restaurant here in the city. I already have a couple in Philly, but you're opening one here in New York. Is that right?
Yeah, I'm opening Amada, our Spanish tapas restaurant, at Brookfield Place.
Oh, wow. Congratulations, man. That's incredible. Yeah, so what toppings work well with the lamb tacos?
So with the lamb, I go kind of Mediterranean. I have a little mint pipián, which is a kind of like a mint pesto.
Pipián?
Pipián.
Never heard of pipián before.
A little bit of feta.
Okay.
Some radish. And, yeah, just a little bit of chopped cilantro.
You know, I'm going to go ahead and bring our fine ladies back. I feel selfish.
Awesome.
Out here grubbing by myself. Come on. You guys can't bring a lamb taco?
Have a little lamb taco.
Yeah. We have a crab guacamole, lastly. Is that too?
That's right. Yeah, we have a little crab guac.
Oh.
Get in there.
Oh, look, it's so juicy.
It's so juicy. That's
I have to go in. Crab guac. Oh my God.
So what's the key to the crab guacamole? What's the key to your guacamole?
My key is fresh roasted jalapenos, fresh lime juice, and really trying to do it as close to the time when your guests arrive.
Mm-hmm. And I love the amount of crab in there.
Mm-hmm. Listen, more crab, more better.
It's nice. Yeah.
Everything is so delicious.
Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.
And happy Cinco de Mayo. Happy Cinco. You can get these recipes on our Facebook page for more delicious food from Chef Jose Garces. Visit his restaurants in Philly, Barbara, and his modern Mexican restaurant, Distrito. Coming up, we've got a live performance by Run River North. Keep it here.